next into UFC Heavyweight Showdown. All right, so two truly elite strikers here. We sat down with them on Thursday and asked them any thoughts of taking this fight to the ground. They want to strike.
They want to strike. That's the style of the show. That is the path that they are normally on. And tonight they get someone that allows them to fight in their comfort zone. They don't have to worry about defending takedowns. All they have to worry about is, oh, he's hurt bad.
Oh, big knee there. Now a knee. Oh. Back to the knee. Lands a big right hand early.
He's hurt bad.
His opponent squirming like a fish out of water now. Ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning.
This could be the beginning of the end.
Down there as he forces the miss from his opponent.
So he's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. These are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. Really using his reach advantage there with that land, DC.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Well, he has certainly found the range and staying pretty busy here on the field.
He's being busy, but it's also the timing and the accuracy that's allowing him to land so many attacks.
Just misses with a left hook there.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one?
Oh, uppercut to the head, DC. Now we'll see if he can follow it up.
His opponent was doing a great job of seeing the punches coming straight at him. Running fast strikes to throw at the exact right moment. He deserves this moment. Don't finish the fight. Now he's on top of him looking for a finish.
He's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
All right, he's sort of hanging out here unguarded, DC. Not sure if he's trying to bait him in or what, but not great body language here. In the tail of the tape, DC. He's got the reach advantage and certainly made good use of it there in landing that check.
Especially if you are fighting someone that doesn't truly understand that they're not in as much danger as they are. Because it's dangerous, but there are a lot of outs. And if a person isn't very understanding of that, then you can really, really put some damage on them.
Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots in the top.
His opponent knows where he is.
No, he doesn't know where he is. He hurts real bad. That punch landed in the perfect spot. Yeah, he mixed it all up.
Well, he's been pretty accurate tonight. He's landed some significant strikes, but his corner's looking for him to mix it up a little bit more and just throw it.
Oh, he hurt bad. He hurt bad, John. He's got to press him. Should be disappointed in their performance.
We now go inside the octagon where Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Contest at 1 minute, 45 seconds of round number 3. Declaring the winner by knockout.
Well, we congratulate him on a huge knockout.